Let me stop it. I'm gonna listen to it, the rest of it myself. I should have just done the hook. Mainly, what I wanted to say was cheers to the aunts and the uncles. A lot of y'all ain't gonna get no phone call, so I wanted to say it myself to you. It's one of my titles, and I don't remember getting a phone call to say that. Somehow, when you don't have biological or bonus children of your own, known as stepchildren to most people, you ain't seen as a very important in society. So, I'm saying cheers to myself, too. Mm-hmm. Magnanimous. Moving mindset Monday, July 26th. Yeah, July 26th. Ooh. 2021. Instagram. I almost feel like eating. This is the Save Our Marriage Empowerment segment. We do that with prayer, reflection, inspiration, courageous conversation, encouragement, enlightenment, evolvement. This is episode number 187. They're not for everyone. And I'm all right with that because this is an assignment that I accepted after dodging it for more than a decade. So, these are for healthy-minded folks, husbands, wives, who jumped all in. Yeah, you went from your own self-reliance and independence to become interdependent, build a bridge, lift one another up, and open up doors because you want the best for and from one another. Yeah, you love, you have pure intentions, you're faithful, you're committed, you know, kind. Anyone that has an issue with this, because I'm not yet in legal covenant, take it up with the Lord. Take it up with the Lord. And if you want some verses to read, I'll give that to you. It's my desire that you look at the vision and masterpiece that you are creating. I believe that marriage is a ministry. It's God's art. We're the ones that have the paintbrushes to add to the masterpiece. And it becomes what we make it. We choose. Today, I'm not going to forget to do the LDD. Something small that I wanted to share with you is that what we believe in our minds, we can hold and have in our lives. Not only do we need to stay grateful, we need to get aligned. Folks getting divorced. Folks talking about divorce. We see it so often. Let them be your motivators, okay? And by that I mean to remain faithful, to remain committed, to remain loyal and loving in your own marriage, to be the outliers. Yeah. So that when you say happy anniversary or someone says it to you, you know, you ain't done nothing to one another to cause any kind of pain. And it's really legit. Yeah. Be the outliers. Let somebody else's divorce be your motivation, your inspiration to stay committed. Let them inspire you to keep rising. What your successful, faithful, building marriage represents. Those who believe in God and stay connected to the source. Y'all know darkness can be all around. It never stops. The enemy is always seeking. Go and look at the scripture when he's asked, what are you doing? Oh, going here and there, seeking, looking for who I can devour. And then guess what that question was? Have you considered my servant Job? Well, I have, but you have protection, this hedge all around him. I can't even get to him. So be it. I'll take the hedge down. You do anything you want. You can't take his life. Be the outlier. All right. Darkness all around. Just don't let it get inside. the darkest time of the evening, what do we see? We see stars shine. Be that star. Okay? It doesn't take long to work on a marriage that can last long. Healthy mindsets speak life about how they can help whatever they choose to commit to work. Yeah. You were made with love. You were made for love. You were made to love. You're fit for love. You should want to leave this world laughing. You know, the gates of hell, they didn't prevail. And they won't prevail inside of anything that is ordained. Because you're committed. You ain't messing up this good thing. Gone, devil. Yeah, I know. I see what's going on out there. It ain't happening up in here. Want to be able to see God with a smile on my face. I don't want to hear depart from me, worker of iniquity. Come on here. So, we see all of that. And the biggest one of last week that we ended up seeing in the news and being reported on, Dr. Dre. And, you know, everybody's focusing on the amount of money that he's going to be paying to his ex-wife that he was unfaithful to. Whether or not she chose to do that too, when it's ordained and you want to be the outlier and you want God to beam with pride, ain't nobody coming inside. You ain't gonna let nobody outside come inside, infiltrate, contaminate, death. No. So, go ahead. I ain't saying that we making fun of somebody that's gotten divorced. Nope, because that doesn't mean that life is over. But when you are ordained and married, that's not your focus. Your focus, your thought is, all right, what we need to discuss. Have we checked in lately? Have we evaluated lately? Is there something else that I can do to help make your life better? How am I doing so far? Did you like this? Did you like that? Talk with me. The LDD is 207. It says love chooses to bless. Love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you and bless those who curse you. Pray for those who mistreat you. Luke 6:27-28 from the vantage point of the wedding altar. You never would have dreamed that the person that was standing across from you might become kind of an enemy. One you would need to love as an act of almost total sacrifice. Yet, far too often in marriage, the relationship does indeed dwindle down to that level. Wow. Y'all know I don't read these beforehand. Thank you for connecting it, because I had no idea. I had no idea. For many, this is the beginning of the end. Some respond by rapidly moving towards a tragic divorce. I'm not laughing at what's being read. I'm laughing because God has a sense of humor. Because when I was writing this, I just wrote this yesterday. Because I was like, what am I supposed to be saying? Am I reading from the book or just doing the LDD? And I came and wrote that yesterday. And look at this. Good. If you see a tear drop from my eye, just, man. Wow. When I say this is an assignment. And then there are moments that I question whether or not it really is. And you know what? My high power, creator, source, Allah, Yahweh, Jehovah, God, the Lord, buddy, never ceases to give me some kind of extra sign. Woo! All right. For many, this is the beginning of the end. And some respond by rapidly moving toward a tragic divorce. Others, more protective of their reputation than even their own happiness, decide to keep the charade going. Woo! But they have no intention of liking it, much less loving each other again. This is not the model for the follower of God. If love is to be like the Lord's, we must love even when its overtures are returned unwanted. Again, none of my episodes are about abuse. None of them. Mm-mm. Want us to stay in something abusive? The Lord ain't saying that. No. No. The blessings of the Lord make it rich and add no sorrow. Okay? We must bless regardless of the response. Really, that should have been reaction, because reactions are usually not positive. Responses are thought through, and they are on the more positive side. For our love to be like that, it must be God's love to begin with. Love gives, lust takes. Lohart, the prayer is, help us to love one another with your love. Teach us to forgive quickly and not to be easily offended. Remind us to keep no record of wrongs. Even better, remind us not to do wrong. We think before we act, because what we believe and think about is what we receive. We can't plant a seed of negativity and expect positivity to grow. Can't expect something positive to grow from something negative. Mm-mm. Remind us, as I've said before, most of us know. We know what can hurt someone. Don't do it. We, unlike furry babies, have the capacity and the ability to make choices. So we know we're about to do something. We didn't just slip and fall in it. More often than not, we made that decision. We made the choice. Oh my gosh. For those of you replay viewers that come in, I appreciate your time. Thank you for gifting me with some of it. Those of you that I call my lovelies that actually say something to me, bless you. Much love, much love, much love. Oh my gosh. Do everything in love. Walk in love, talk in love, look in love, speak in love, lead with love and in love, follow in love and with love. Do everything with love. Make it a lovely day, not just for you. Find someone else and help them have a lovely day too. Wow. This has been the Save Our Marriage Empowerment segment, episode 187. The LDD was 207. I am Jesse C. Love. Teacher love, coach love. Happy Uncle and Aunt Day to those of you who are. And if no one's going to tell you, I said it. Not a lot of you will see it, but it was said. All right? Be love. Instagram. My gosh. You know what? I'm going to save this and put it on YouTube. Yeah. Be magnanimous today. Keep the mindset positive as much as possible. You know, honestly, I'm grateful just to wake up with my right mind. The activity of my limbs, being able to do activities and actions on my own. Is everything grand and wonderful? No. I'm learning to focus more on the positives. Because there could be a different testimony right now. Much different. And even though there are challenges and friction, it could be a lot worse. I brought up Job. Hello. I used to call myself Jobette because of everything I kept going through. My God. I'm gonna go. Love you.